Upon then, as India looks to extend the three-week nationwide lockdown, pesticides have been included under essential items. We have two companies who join us now. We have Mr. Rajesh Aggarwal, MD of Insecticides India, and Mr. RG Aggarwal, Chairman of Danuka Agritech, who joins us on the phone line. Well, thanks so much, gentlemen, for joining in. Coming across to you, Mr. Rajesh Aggarwal, could you tell us how much of Insecticides India's revenue comes in from pesticides and rough capacity utilization levels that you all are functioning at?
Previous products what we used to manufacture was categorized broadly as insecticides.
Okay.
And now the new PMB has come, which says that all the products we manufacture are going to come under PMB. So it means they will be called pesticides. So now 100% products which I make are called pesticides. So we have been allowed to work on all the products what we manufacture. But the permissions which are granted to us to run our factory are for limited manpower. So from 30 to 100 different units, different locations, different sanctions are allowed. So people are allowed, which means that today broadly the factories are trying to function at about 20 to 25% capacity because there are various bottlenecks which we are facing. Because there are lot of local problems of the local department because you have to take the permission from the local SDMs and other offices. And apart from that, there are lot of problems from police also to take the passes. So the managers are not able to go, some senior people are not able to go, and then we have to convince the people also to join the company. So there are some villages which are obstructing the people from moving out of their villages. So there is a problem. So, but I can say that we have started our operations in 70% of our units with, say, about 20 to 25% manpower.
Okay.
Okay, fair enough. Thank you, Mr. Aggarwal, Rajesh Aggarwal, for explaining the issues to us. Now I want to go across to the management of Danuka Agritech, Mr. Ram Aggarwal, who's with us as well. Mr. Ram, can you tell us what are the challenges that you're facing at the moment, whether it's in terms of logistics, laborers, transportation, and at what capacity utilization are you functioning currently? How much do you think that would go to over the next, say, 2 to 3 months?
Madam, first of all, I will like to appreciate our government that they have taken timely decision and saved us from becoming Europe or USA. The problems are all common, which just Rajesh said. Labor is a problem, transportation is a problem, local administration's problem in spite of passes, the adjudicating machinery, especially police department, they don't understand. The permission is also given for limited labor. No permission is given to private vehicles, four-wheelers or two-wheelers. And until less, you see, no country can compromise for their food, nutrition, health, wealth, and environment security. Considering this, government has declared it as a priority sector because pesticides play the most crucial role in our food security. Now, this rabi crop is ready and kharif crop sowing will start. For harvesting and for storage, pesticides are needed. For new crop sowing, pesticides are needed. So one side we will fight with COVID, but other side if we don't care for our future food requirement, then it will be a problem. So all this administrative hurdle, of course, Home Ministry is advising to state government secretaries to allow and issue the passes. But I don't know, in spite of central government instructions, why state governments are not freely allowing industry to work, for example, food industry or flour mills or any such item which is a day-to-day need. Stores are getting empty and people are not getting the goods. So this is very, very urgent and important that Home Secretary should talk on con call to all state secretaries, advising them that all essential commodity industry should be allowed without hindrance, so national food security should not be stake again.
Okay, got that. So that's a very important point you made, Mr. Ram, that there are a lot of bottlenecks from the state government's end, although the central government is doing a lot. But until these bottlenecks ease, it may take some time. Until then, what is the production loss that Dhanuka Agritech is looking at? How much has the production hit been already? And what do you expect over the next 2 to 3 months?
You see, production loss has, after permission, we have started in our two factories. Udhampur, still permission has not been received. So we are in position to operate at 20-30% level at present. Hello?
Sir.
Hello?
Yes, Mr. R.G. Aggarwal.
At present, we are in position to operate at 20-30% level.
Okay.
Because for production, you need packaging material.
Okay.
You need various spare parts for your plant and machinery.
Okay.
Some such small things.
So 20-25% is what you're functioning at currently, right?
Yes.
Okay. Mr. R.G. Aggarwal, you know, the last time you joined us in February, you were quite optimistic that you have the required supplies. And for quarter four, you could do around 20% in terms of growth for the fourth quarter. Obviously, things have changed because second half of March, the entire nation did come to a virtual standstill. What would that revised number be for quarter four?
It will be double-digit growth.
Okay.
But exactly, I am not in position to
tell. All right. Okay. Okay, let's get Mr. Rajesh Aggarwal then into this discussion. Mr. Rajesh Aggarwal, could you tell us, Insecticides India, what is the rough fixed cost that you operate at on a monthly basis? Employees, will you all be taking some kind of salary cut, maybe the top end, or will you all be retrenching some staff? What is the strategy?
It's very difficult to deal with the manpower, actually. So in the month of March, we have not deducted a single paisa out of the salary of anybody.
Okay.
Though if we are forced to keep this continue for a longer time, then we'll have to definitely think, because company cannot fund it alone. So at the moment, we have not planned, and we are looking like when we got the opportunity last week, we started our units at whatever 20-30% capacity. And now we are in a position that whenever the things are opened up, we can multiply this utilization, because the manpower will be conveniently coming in that case, because at this moment, the manpower is the biggest restriction. And as R.J. Aggarwalji told, that a lot of ancillary units which are a support required, because today I need engineering goods, I need different raw materials, packaging materials, all the things are needed if I have to run the plant smoothly.
Mm-hmm.
So the smooth movement of all these activities along with the logistics is very, very important. In some of our depots also, because the stocks are from the factory have to move to the depots, there are restrictions. Some depots are opening for 2-3 hours, and at other places, no permission is granted to even open for a single hour, which means that a lot of trucks are stranded in the way, and they have not reached the depots also. So it is becoming very difficult to fulfill the entire thing. So maybe the center will have to plan a little better, open up where the industries are able to function, and the smooth supplies of things are maintained if we want to avoid the shortages of agrochemical and food in the coming quarter, because it is very, very important, and the kharif season sowing period is very, very near. So the placement of all the things is very, very important, because the coronavirus hit China 2 months before. So that 2 months, the entire supply chain from China was restricted. So our suffering, particularly of our industry, has been quite long, because for almost 3 months,
right,
we are operating at a smaller capacity.
Okay. All right. Thanks so much, Mr. Rajesh Aggarwal of Insecticides India, and Mr. R.G. Aggarwal as well of Dhanuka Agritech. So they're trying to start operations. Currently, they're functioning anything between 20 to around 30% odd because of the reduced labor. But they're optimistic that they can, raise these capacity utilization levels going ahead. And also they say there are still logistical issues that they hope that they can sort out in the time to come. Well, let's slip into a short break. You come back, we'll continue our focus on markets as well as on a couple of stocks. Stay with us.